I've started now.
That is true now. Look at her. Oh boy, at last.
You know, I stayed back just to bid you and your husband goodbye because I'm traveling to London tonight.
Oh, tonight?
Yeah.
Wow.
I have to go. You know, my visa will expire in a few days' time.
Oh, I see.
We're so grateful, Sarah. Thank you. Thank you so much.
It's okay. It's all right.
Wow. So you're leaving us this night?
Yeah, I just have to go.
Well, we're really going to miss you.
I was about saying that. I will miss you greatly, honestly.
What can I say? When you hit it big in London, don't forget us.
Abiu. Let's pray for the best. Well, I will advise that both of you should live in peace. Okay? Try to sustain each other at all times. That was the summary of what the pastor said at the church yesterday.
Well, thank you for your care and for your advice.
It's all right.
Sarah, you're my friend indeed. Thank you.
Well, we've come a long way.
Thank you. Thank you for everything. Let's give you some time, some space, so you can have a little nap and put your things together.
Exactly, because I want to.
Yeah,
I want to take a nap then, put my things together.
And you know, for me, honeymoon starts.
I beg you.
Okay, so latest marriage.
Don't let me oversleep or wake me up.
Okay.
So,
I'm not feeling sleepy.
Why? Is anything wrong?
Well, I've just been thinking about a lot of things. I just feel that I'm not doing enough for you. You know, taking you away from your parents, I mean, you deserve better than you're getting.
Who's complaining?
I am complaining.
I know my husband. He works hard and he has potentials. Okay? Money will come when it will come. But for now,
Felix, how are you?
Fine.
You're welcome. Please sit down.
Thank you.
Honey, maybe you should get something for Felix.
Why not?
No, madam. Don't worry. I'm not in a good mood for food. Thank you very much.
What is the problem?
You remember what happened before your wedding? How I smuggled my gas vehicle to help you out? Then my guy traveled. Now he's back. And someone went and told him everything. How I used the vehicle.
Oh, Jesus. Who could have done a thing like that?
I don't know. He even accused me that I used the vehicle for my private business.
Honey, what do we do?
We'll go and see him and explain to him.
And apologize to him?
Yeah. I think he wants to sack me.
Sack you?
Yes.
How can he sack you? Listen, he won't sack you. We'll go and meet him, explain things to him and apologize him, at least exonerate you. Because it's not fair that you should lose your job on account of helping us. No, it's not fair. We'll go and see him and apologize to him.
Is your boss a difficult person?
Honey, it's not a question of being difficult here. If I were in his boss's shoes, I would probably feel the same way. So we'll just go and explain things to him and apologize on your behalf. I'll try to exonerate you, okay? Look, sit down. You have to eat something, honey. Please go ahead and get him something to eat.
Okay. It's okay.
We could have gone and told him, something like that. People just don't mind their business.
Yeah, who's it?
Dan, the newest hired man in town.
Sit down. So, to what do I owe this August visit?
Where is madam?
Oh, she went to the market.
Huh?
Yeah, to the market.
This world is a wonderful place. So, then, we cease to go to the market to buy things for himself.
Yes, you can say that again.
No more buying garri, salt, pepper.
No more going to the market to buy crayfish, to buy ogbono, to buy whatever. I have my better half who does it for me now.
I envy you.
You're just sitting down there. I don't know why you're wasting time. What is holding you from taking Ngozi to the altar? Or are you waiting to start doing school runs during your pension?
Don't worry. Very soon, the network news will carry my wedding announcement.
Let's wait and see.
I won't disappoint
you. In the meanwhile, what would you like to drink?
Don't worry. Don't waste your honeymoon drinks on me.
Are you saying you're not drinking anything?
Yeah, anyway, marketing manager asked me to.
Give me this. What does he want? What is the meaning of this? That I should come back to work on Monday morning? Have they forgotten I'm on leave for my honeymoon?
No, but your presence is highly needed. As a matter of fact, a team of auditors will be coming to the company before our annual general meeting in August. And you are the only person that can straighten things out in your department. We need speed, we need accuracy, we need you, Mr. Dan.
Yeah. They need me. When they need you, they start pouring encomiums on you. But when it's time for salaries and honorariums, they turn their faces the other way. Look, I'm not going anywhere. Period.
Please, Dan, you're highly needed.
Oh. Why can't they just allow me enjoy my honeymoon in the peace and serenity of my home? I was actually getting used to just sitting at home and, having things done for me, like, my wife has gone to the market, she'll come back and cook and take care of things, and I'll just relax, what I mean?
Yes, yes, this is Dan Obioza speaking. Yes, I sent you a perfumer invoice. Yes, 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 for the supply of some produce from Nigeria. Cocoa, shea nut and cashew nut. Yes, I did. A trial shipment? 50,000 metric tons. Oh yes, we can do that. Yes, yes, we can do over a 1 year period, we can do at least about 200,000 metric tons of the different produce. Yes, yes. Okay, okay. Oh, I'll get on it right away. We will start working on it right away. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, we'll be waiting for your letter of credit. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Stock issue was tabled in our last meeting, but as far as I'm concerned, the matter is still in abeyance in that the deliberation was inconclusive.
And Mrs.
Mr. Dan Obioza, you're welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank
you. Please do sit down.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Dan Obioza,
sir.
We, the board members of this company, wish to express our happiness with you and that you got our letter and you responded promptly.
Thank you, sir.
But all the same, we are sorry for cashing in on the piece of your honeymoon.
That's okay, sir.
Our auditors have finally shown us the green light. The date is August 29th through September 10th. So shall we?
Sir, are you saying that they can conclude the auditing of the company's whole accounts in less than 2 weeks?
Does it sound impossible?
Well, I would like to see how they intend to accomplish that, because we're going to have to get reports from various departments and each one must be carefully examined. It's not a classroom assignment.
Now you have passed the test. You see why we needed you desperately? Mr. Obioza, now on a very serious note, the accounts department count on you for a very clean job.
Yes, sir, but I'm not the chief accountant.
Mr. Dan, we have our reasons for that, okay?
Okay. When are the auditors coming?
October 25th, precisely.
Well, I'll do my best. I have no choice.
Good. Good. Congratulations on your wedding once again.
Hello, baby.
How was your day?
Good. And how was yours?
Fine.
I see a certain radiance.
Listen, I am famished. Do you have anything ready?
Ready to be served.
Good. Please sit down. I'll go straight to the table.
Good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon.
Is this Mr. Dan Obioza's house?
Oh, yes.
Please, I have a mail for him.
Okay, I'll receive it. I'm his wife.
Okay. Just...
Alright.
Sign here for him.
I started working with this company. I discovered that there were some transactions that were not successful, and I asked why, and they told me one of them was for the exportation of some produce to the United States, and I got them to commit that if I could swing it, that for every ton of produce shipped I would make $1. And now the company has written back that they need 200,000 metric tons of shea nut and cocoa, but that we can start with 50,000 shipment as trial.
Well, let me get that.
Sit down. 50,000 metric tons means $50,000.
Times 140.
7 million naira. And then we have 200 tons to ship over a period of 12 months.
Am I talking to a millionaire here?
Indeed, you are talking to the latest millionaire in town. $200,000. My goodness, it means almost 30 million naira. Can you believe what that means?
Oh, congratulations. Congratulations.
I can't believe this. I am, well, from now on, I'm going to be my own boss, and we'll open an office and have my own staff and be given instructions. No, but the first 50,000 metric tons, I am going to personally supervise the shipment, so that is already in the bag. You can be sure of that.
I'm so happy for you. I'm happy.
Oh, this is good news.
Yes, yes.
Woo!
All right.
Sit down.
Simply working out the way they should.
Hey, what if I take you on a second honeymoon to America?
Dad, finish the contract first.
Let me tell you this before I start it. I will always love you with all my heart. You're my jewel of inestimable value.
I know. And I appreciate every bit of it.
Together we'll conquer the world.
Can somebody just leave poetry and let's eat?
Okay, let's eat.
Oga has bought a new car.
Agadan.
Felix, Agadan. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Oh,
you didn't tell her?
No, not just yet. Use this for your transport.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Please, as you're going, close the gate for me.
Thank you, ma. Congratulations. Thank you, Agadan.
Congratulations.
So we'll see you later now.
All right, now. See you later.
Okay, thank you. Bye bye.
Okay.
Congratulations.
For this. What is it now? Is your car? Is your car? Have the key.
And it's not joking.
Take the key from me. It's your car.
Oh, honey, this is not right now. This is not right. I mean, how can I be driving this and my husband is driving a Golf? This is not right. Come on.
Am I complaining? Oh, by the way, still smelling very fresh.
You're unbelievable.
You're welcome. You deserve more than this.
You're unbelievable.
Thank you. Well, let's go and fill the machine.
Okay. Yeah, no, you drive. Me. I mean, must all this hurricane have a female name attached to it?
Well, not necessarily. You know, before Katrina and Rita, there was Hurricane Ivan. That was a long time ago.
Uh-huh.
Katrina was probably because of the governor of New Orleans. It was a woman.
Well, whatever they do. But maybe we should begin to think of Hurricane Isolo, Hurricane Gabito, and all that. And it will make more sense to me.
Hurricane Collins. No, that will come from his village. That's well, where the hurricane will start.
Look, there shouldn't be any attempt of hurricane around here. Otherwise, anyway. I think God knows better than that. Sweetheart, mm-hmm. Have you ever thought about owning a house in the village or anywhere in the city?
No. Why do you ask?
Because very soon the contract will be over. I mean, you've been busy playing Danny the Millionaire, throwing parties for everybody, buying me a car.
Look, what are you afraid of? That the money will finish?
Okay. I admit, I'm afraid.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's just say, very soon, the contract will be over. I mean, one has to be in total control.
I agree with you.
It amazes me that you never think of investing or owning landed property.
Well, that's why it is good to marry a wife that can influence you positively.
Is that to say we can invest?
We are saying as soon as you show me any landed property, we'll start investing.
Then I'll show you one. Today.
After no problem.
That would be after this. Yes, so tonight I can sleep well.
Intelligent angel.
Just be intelligent enough not to pour the rice on the floor.
Junior, look at the way he's eating like an adult. By the way, I got a letter from my former company inviting me to come back as their new accounts manager.
No. You have set up your own company, you have set your own standards. They should find another accounts officer.
Well, I agree with you. You have a point there.
Hello, please, my kid.
Past 4 days. Yes.
How did you get this number?
No, I lost my phone, so I tried getting your line. I got Ngozi at the airport. You know Ngozi now? Yes, she gave me your number.
Really? Oh, this is nice. Where are you?
I'm in the hotel, Royal Palace Hotel.
Why lodge in a hotel?
Nora, I didn't want to disturb you. I didn't want to...
Oh, come off it. I live in a big house. There are too many rooms here. As a matter of fact, I don't know what to do with all the rooms. No, now, ah! story. Oh, my friend, listen, you were part of this marriage. You're not a stranger in my home. Now, you're all you did talk. I'm coming to pick you right away.
Oh, thank you. Okay, I'll wait for you. Yeah, I'm right here. I'm in the hotel right now, yes. I'll wait for you.
Bye-bye, I'm coming now. Bye.
Can become intoxicating when it is served by a juicy lady. Chief, it's you. Actually, at the moment, I'm in a conference. Yes, I'm going through the documents, as a matter of fact. Yeah, the consignment is worth 5 million. And then the second one is 50 million. Well, of course, we'll start with the first one. I mean, 5 million is a little amount of money. Then, probably come September, we'll take the third consignment, which is worth 72 million. Yes. Okay. I'll be meeting you up later at the club. Then we can discuss some more in detail. Oh, no, it's nothing. All right, I'll see you later. Okay. Now, where did we stop?
Yes. Okay, Chief, we'll be meeting at the club. Yeah. All right, thank you very much.
John. Well, I have listened to your story, and I can imagine how terrible you must feel. I mean, those are the vagaries of working for people, be it a government establishment or a private establishment. You are at their beck and call. They can take their aggression from home and transfer it to you. It is good for you to think of something that you can do. I mean, look at me now. I'm on my own. I run my business. Nobody can come here and tell me any jack. I come to work when I want to come to work. I have a certain drive because I know I'm doing my own thing. Everything I invest is for me. We've been friends for a long time, and I just can't sit by and watch you have such a bad turn and not do something about it. I mean, you deserve better than that. So you think of something you can do. Let me assist in my own way. This is a check for 1 million naira. Go ahead, take it.
₦1 million for me?
Just think of anything you can do and see how you can use this to start. I think you deserve to be on your own. I trust that you're going to use it wisely. The only appreciation that I expect from you is to use this and make something out for yourself.
I lack words to express how I feel. God will bless you.
The journey.
God will definitely bless you.
You're welcome.
Dan!
My God will bless you. I wish you all the best. Welcome.
Thank you.
How is Europe?
Europe is as busy as Lagos.
Can you believe that she's been back now for 4 days?
4 days?
And that she's been hanging out in a hotel.
Why?
Nora, but I told you, I lost my old phone. So I was like looking for your numbers, even the old number. You know, I couldn't get them. I was looking for somebody to give me until I ran into Ngozi, our friend, who gave it to me.
Another thing to believe, Ngozi has this number, but she has never called this house.
Well, you're welcome.
Thank you very much. Thanks. Oh, how time flies. You already have 2 kids.
I'm doing well.
You do well, baby.
Time does fly indeed. God has been good.
Oh, yes.
Honey, can you rustle up something from the kitchen?
Yeah, something's already cooking, but let's just see how far.
Okay.
All right, girl. Lovely baby.
Look at this one. He loves food so much, he's running after his mother to go to the kitchen.
It's natural. It's natural. Dan, God has really blessed you, you know.
Well, God has been very, very good. Yeah. Very good. How come you didn't bother contacting us all these years?
Oh, man, it's not easy to survive in Europe, you know? Racism, you know, political on the line, you know, and all that. It's not easy living in Europe. It's not easy to survive there.
So, what kind of business was this?
Well, I'll confide in you. I was involved in child trafficking.
Child what?
Don't shout. I regret all my past ventures. I was into child trafficking before, you know, luck ran out on my business.
Since when?
Since my elder sister threw me out of her house in London. I met a couple of friends that introduced me to the business.
Have you gone to see your parents?
My parents? My parents are no more.
Yeah.
And all our family gold diggers deserted all of us when they know that the good days were over. I'm just on my own. Even my elder sister is there in London speaking some big English. She doesn't really hoot a damn about anybody down home here. So, well, Laura, all I want now is somewhere to be. And somebody like you to lean on. So, your friend is all on her own now.
Well, once in a while we all stand on our own. But I think what is most important now is that we'll try and see who can get you a job.
That is it. That is exactly what I'm talking about. I can say that you people are so big now and I think I'm lucky there.
Okay, I'll talk to Danny about this and then let's see what we can do about your job.
Asked you to do all this, and because you refused, they didn't want to pay your salary.
Hi,
welcome, honey. Our friend Felix is in some sort of trouble.
Trouble?
You know, since his master died, his master's sons have been pushing him beyond limit. Sending him to the market to buy food items or do menial things, and even asking him to connive with them to steal vehicles.
No.
On top of it all, they've not been paying him his salary regularly.
What kind of story is that?
I was just thinking, maybe we could Felix.
Agada.
Would you like to be my personal driver?
Yes, I will. I will.
Okay. When would you like to start?
Now.
No, that's too soon. See what will happen. Move your things in tomorrow. You'll be staying at the boys' quarters. And when you come, we'll discuss your salary. Is that okay?
Hey, thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
You don't know what you have done for me. Thank you very much.
Thank you, God.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you. Agada. Thank you, sir. Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Everything will be all right, huh?
Okay. Thank you, sir. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Have a nice day.
You just made one person very happy.
Well, one good turn deserves another. He's been a faithful sort of guy over the years.
I know, one of your faithful friends on the other side.
Well, I thought you were getting me a drink.
Drink. You know, whenever you say drink, I know what that's needed.
Well, it's not a bad proposition.
Okay. Sure, still.
Now, off you go. Go get me my drink.
Okay. I'll get it.
What are you doing?
Fixing my nail polish.
That thing has a choking smell.
I'm through. Sweetheart, I want you to do something for me.
What is it?
Can I ask you a favor?
Name it, please.
My friend Sarah, and she needs a job or maybe connection to get one.
And I'm supposed to give her a job?
No, well, what's wrong with giving her a job?
Nothing, it's just that,
please, for me.
Okay, let us see me in my office. Wait. I'm not promising anything yet. Don't celebrate.
Yes, okay.
I will interview her and see if she can fit in anywhere. That's all I can promise for now.
Okay. Thank you, my darling. Thank you. And you too. Oh yeah! I know my husband. Have a lovely day. Yes, I got it. Ooh, I got it. Ooh, yes.
Yes, she was pleading on your behalf with regards to getting a job. So I told her
well, that I will have to interview you first to see if something can be worked out.
Okay. Thank you. I think I have my credentials here.
No, 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 don't bother. I don't need to see your credentials at this stage. You're not new to me, and I know all about your academic qualifications. You see, we, in this country, we run a system of give and take.
I don't understand that.
I'm sure you're computer literate.
Oh, yes.
You know about garbage in, garbage out.
Okay, I think I'm conversant with that word. Input and output system?
That's correct, but it's just that within this context, the rate of input is not always equal to the rate of output.
You talk as if you want to attach me to your computer department.
Sarah, please. Let's cut the bullshit. It's as simple as this. Be my woman, and I'll give you more than what you desire.
You mean I should?
I have always loved you.
Damn. You mean I should have an affair with you? Forgetting that my best friend is your wife?
I love you, Sarah. That's what matters.
And what about the love you confessed to your wife on your wedding day? Where has that gone?
Sarah, do you want a job? Or do you want to sit down here questioning me?
I'm sorry. I cannot have an affair with you. Good day.
I thought somebody with your level of exposure would be able to understand these things. Pity.
Excuse me.
If you change your mind, the job is still yours.
Interview go? Not successful. What do you mean not successful?
Laura, the questions were so, so tough. I could only answer two. So from the look of things, I know I won't make it.
Is there a way you're brooded? Oh, come on. Even if you got all the questions wrong, my husband is capable of switching you to a good position. Okay? That interview was just mere formality.
But you know your husband. He's a disciplined man, a profile person, and he believes in all this computer.
Save me the introduction. I know my husband. I married him.
Reggie, let's go eat. Get up, I cooked my special. Let's go eat a big let's go. What is all this?
Let's go and beg.
Something special. Ordinary interview that my friend comes back.
Wow, I've had enough of
it. Oh, come on. This is just ice cream.
Sorry, I'm okay. I don't want to lose my shit.
Okay, no problem. Well, shall we?
Sorry.
Let's relax now. Oh, I mean, you still have about 30 minutes to go back to the office. Oh.
I know one or two things we can do in 30 minutes. I mean, that's why I want us to spend it wisely and have some quality time together.
Like?
Oh, come now, don't tell me.
Tell me, like
hey,
what?
Hey, 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 I've already taken a room somewhere in the hotel.
Booked a room?
Mm-hmm.
No, you should have told me. Oh, right now, I hate it.
And I prefer it that way.
Prefer it that way?
Yes, I do prefer it that way.
What about the after effects?
What after effects? I mean, from the previous experiences I've had, nobody has complained about any after effects.
See, Rex. Ah! Oh, I want to rush and make a call.
Baby, you can make your call in the privacy and coziness of my room. Come on, let's go. Let's not waste the 30 minutes. It's now about 2 minutes I've already gone, so let's go and spend it quietly.
Laura, you're back.
It's not Laura, it's her husband.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Dan, I didn't enjoy that.
So, what would you want me to do to you?
Hi, sweetie.
Oh, hi.
You're home?
Yes, yes. I came to pick up a file I had forgotten.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
You drove yourself. Where's Felix?
Had to. Felix is fixing the other car.
Okay.
Well, I'll be on my way.
All right, ma'am.
You're back.
Yes. Oh. I actually went across the road. Our neighbor, she just had a baby.
Oh, okay.
Well, what have you been up to?
Fault that we have a loving daddy and husband.
Who deserves to be disturbed, huh?
No, who deserves companionship.
I see. In that case, come and share my seat. Junior, come over here. So, what can I do for you?
It's taking you so long to recommend my friend for a job. Sarah is a very nice girl, you know. Remember how she almost lost her chance of going abroad because of us? Honey, Sarah deserves the best from us.
Sarah is not intelligent enough. Haven't I said this before?
Who said that? Who conducted that interview? Sarah is very clever.
It's not all the time that cleverness and intelligence mean the same thing.
Then help her.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to sound bossy. Wasn't even supposed to be harsh.
No problem.
So, what are we saying?
What are we not saying?
What is this on the job? Better say something.
Sarah, do you think you have upset Dan in any way?
No, why? Because it's strange. He's finding it so difficult to make up his mind on what to do for you.
Laura, the problem here is that you think it's only your husband that can help me. Don't you think I can as well go out and look elsewhere for a job?
Well, I know, but... Anyway, well, let me just keep talking to him, okay? I don't think all hope is lost yet. Let me keep talking and then you keep praying.
I will, thank you. It's not as if I have anything against your husband. No, I don't.
Okay, I'll talk to him. Okay. Meantime, just relax and then let me see if I can help the children with their homework.
Okay. I'll see you later. For you.
Why is it taking you so long to make up your mind and say yes to me?
Dan, I hate your conditions.
See, I've already made out a check of 200,000 naira for you as a congratulatory gesture. I know good girls take time to make up their minds.
Your wife is my best friend. Can't you understand?
You leave that to me. I can handle this thing so well, she will not even suspect there's anything between us.
Nothing can ever happen between us.
Where is the love you promised? Where is the faithfulness you promised your love? Can't you look into her heart with the eyes of love? Look deep inside and see what to be to her.
You think I have completely lost my senses because of marriage? Now you listen to me, Mr. Daniel Obioza. And let me tell you something.
Don't tell me anything. What gave you the right to start monitoring me?
The fact that I'm your wife. The last one was written by Juliana. This one is written by Linda. What'd you take me for?
You go about searching my pockets.
Searching your pockets?
Yes, that's what you do now. You don't have any work to do. You search my pockets.
Search your pockets. Just look at you. Look at you.
Don't you feel embarrassed? Our friend, Sarah, has been here for weeks. It's so difficult for you to help her. Instead, you go around throwing your money at tiny schoolgirls. When was the last time you gave me 100,000 naira for somebody to be asking for 100,000 naira, Fashwebi? When? Shame.
Mind the way you talk to me. Just mind the way you talk to me. Don't make me lay my hands on you.
Where is the love you promised? Where is the faithfulness you promised your love? And to look into her heart with the eyes of love. Look deep inside and see what you mean to her. Don't break her heart. Don't break your home. Don't break your home. Don't cause disaster to a peaceful heart. Show her affection.
Show her affection.
That is what she needed most. Do not cheat. It can kill.
Money is not just the root to all evil. It is inspiration. My Danny has certainly developed a huge appetite for young girls. I just hope he's not making advances at Sarah. I hope not. God.
Do not cheat. It can kill a true love. Don't break her heart. Don't break your home. Don't cause disaster to a peaceful heart. Show her affection. That is what she needed most. Do not cheat. It can kill a true love.
Ah, Sarah, have you sent any applications to any other company as you suggested earlier?
Oh, yes. That's been my preoccupation for the greater part of my time now. I've written some application letters to some companies hoping they'll respond soon.
Well, let's just keep our fingers crossed.
Sure.
Sarah, there's something very important that I want to talk to you about.
I want to appeal to you to please not misunderstand me.
What could that be?
There comes a time in a woman's life when she must take some very firm decisions.
Oh, sure.
You have been with us now for over 3 months. I have talked to my husband, but from all indications, he's not willing to help. And I don't know why. Your continuous stay with us here has also...
It's okay, Laura. I think I understand you perfectly well, but I'll plead that you give me some time to, you know, package myself, get an apartment in town and move in as soon as possible.
Sarah, you're running too fast. I didn't say you should move out right away.
It's okay. I'm even ashamed of myself.
It's okay. I think I've really bothered you long enough.
Oh, bother! Mm-hmm. Oh, Sarah, you could never bother me. You are my best friend. And you will always be. This is a rather very difficult decision for me too. But it's okay, Laura. But all the same, are you going to give me some more time to at least sort out myself and move out?
Of course, yes. Yes, I didn't say you should move out now.
Meanwhile, let me take some fresh air outside.
Sarah, I'm sorry about this.
It's okay, Laura.
Frozen bank account. What haven't I done? I've even tried prostitution. I think the heat is on. And this is the time to act. Should I just sit down here and watch stupidity trample on my rights and my common sense? If I must live here, where do I go? Where do I go?
Day, Danny.
Sit down.
Thank you. How is work?
Work is good. I don't remember having an appointment with you.
Oh. I must come on invitation, huh? I'm sorry. I'll see you at home then.
Oh, no. I didn't mean it that way. I was merely joking. Please sit down. So, what can I offer you?
A job, Danny.
All I want you to do for me is give me a job. I know you can do it.
Sarah, the policy still remains the same. Scratch my back, I scratch your back. I'm sure you understand that perfectly well. Come on, Sarah. Don't you understand that I feel something hot for you? I'm inviting you into my world so we can truly appreciate each other like consenting adults.
Okay, Danny, you win. But I tell you something. We must play safe and smart.
I couldn't agree more with you. Now, please, come over to my side. Come over here and give me a hug. Department of your choice. Now let me show you around.
All right.
Well, at least I got a job.
I'm sorry about screaming. Please, no. Okay. Okay, I promise. I'll never search through your pockets. I'll never yell at you again. And please don't turn away from me now. If you turn away, who will look at me? Please.
It's okay, it's okay.
Sorry.
I said it's okay.
About my friend. Can you still find her a place in the office? At least take away some of the frustration from her and keep her busy. Please.
Your friend. I'm only going to consider doing it because you're asking. Otherwise, I don't want to be misunderstood.
But I said I'm sorry. Besides, I know my husband. You'll never run after my friend.
It's okay. Let her come and see me in the office.
Thank you, darling. I missed you so much.
What kind of employment is this?
I just have to give pieces
of music. Oh, my darling. Good afternoon. How was school today?
Fine.
Okay.
Fine? Did he say fine? The head teacher said Junior slept throughout while others were reciting a poem.
Junior, is that true?
Yeah. Oh, my baby. You know why I like you? You would never tell a lie.
So why did you go to school?
To sleep.
Carol, did you sleep too?
No, that one.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, darling. So why don't you go and change, then come downstairs for lunch, okay? Don't go and sleep there.
Alright. So, you know, I don't know how to sit in a place. I just said, let me just do one or two things around the house instead of sleeping.
Yes, I have a bit of a good news.
Good news?
Guess what?
Laura, you know I'm not good at guesses.
What is it?
Try now.
Just guess.
Laura. Don't, look,
one.
Look.
Oh. Laura.
Okay. My husband, Danny, has promised to give you a job.
Job? Laura. So you've been able to convince him? Oh my God, Laura, how can I thank you enough?
Thank me? No.
Oh, Laura.
Anyway, so I think you should just begin to get ready to start work.
Thank God. Okay. So I got a job now.
Congratulations, girl.
Anyway,
I think we should just go and join these kids before lunch turns into wrestling on the mat.
I don't mind. I don't mind.
Oh, baby! So I have a job. Here's your office. What you can do for a start is to get into the system, check out those files I told you about, and tell me what you think.
I can't believe that this office is mine. Oh my God.
Well, this is just the beginning. In the meanwhile, here is a check of 200,000 naira. Use it to upgrade your wardrobe. I'm sure you'll be needing some new things now that you're starting work.
200,000 mm-hmm. for me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, sweetheart, I don't know how to thank you. I don't know how to thank you.
That's okay.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Gosh.
Well, feel at home. I'll see you during lunch.
All right. See ya.
Okay.
Where is the love you promised? Where is the faith?
Oh my God.
You promised your love.
At last.
Can't you look into her heart with the eyes of love?
Oh gosh.
Look deep inside and see what you mean to her. Don't break her heart. Don't break your heart. Don't break your heart. Don't cause disaster.
This is really nice.
It's actually a nice blend.
That is what she needed most.
You deserve much more than this.
It can kill a true love.
Your generosity baffles them.
Well, what would life be if I wasn't generous?
Don't break your heart. Don't cause disaster to a peaceful heart. Show her affection. That is what she needs.
She won't be back for a long while. Her car has a breakdown, so she will spend a long time at the mechanic village.
But remember, we must play safe and smart.
I know.
I want you.
Don't break your home. Don't cause the show her affection. That is what she needed most. Do not cheat. It can kill a true love.
Ah, stop it.
Hey, come here. We have time for a quick take.
Where?
What do you mean,
where? What is it by your time?
I'm sorry, sir. I'm
what is
sorry.
The matter
I'm
with
sorry,
you?
Sir.
I have warned you that I don't joke with my business.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
What's going on here?
Somebody talk to me now, eh?
And what has she done? I hope you haven't started again.
Can you imagine? Look at the time. 10:30 and she's still not in the office. I came back home to pick up a file I had forgotten and I met her in front of the mirror, painting her face all over. I have told you that I hold every department in my company very important. I'm giving you 15 minutes. If I don't see you in the office, you are fired.
Yes, sir.
Your husband is too quick to temper. I was just trying to...
You are here speaking grammar. I only came back to take money to service the car. If I were you, I'll hurry now before
let me pick up my bag upstairs and I'll go.
Please hurry and meet your guy before you get into more trouble. You just put yourself into one trouble one day.
Oh, God. Mr. Danny Smart.
That's me.
You shocked me, you know. I never knew you could think up something that quickly.
Well, experience is the best teacher. I had to do something.
Experience taught you well, oh.
You didn't do badly yourself. You responded promptly.
But you're still teaching me. Don't praise me so much yet.
Hey, where are we going for lunch today? Remember, we can't go to the same place twice in a week.
Yeah, you're right. That's the rule. But meanwhile, I want the 50,000 you promised me last week.
Oh, you think I forgot?
Oh, come now. Is that why your countenance has changed?
Mm-hmm.
Come on. Let's go and eat first, and I'll take care of that.
Mm-mm. The money first.
Oh, please come.
The money first, Danny.
Marriage is ordained by God.
Marriage is ordained
by God.
It is a bed on the
fire.
It is a bed on the fire. God of love that binds to God of love.
Yes, I don't know how to start.
But I just have to start. I want to start by saying thank you. I've always known you as a very nice person. But this time around, you gave me hope when there was none.
Blushing.
No, don't. You gave me life when I thought there was no life anymore.
I came back from Europe with nothing and I didn't know where to start from.
And now you have shown me the light. You disturbed your husband, you made him give me a job. And right now, I have saved some money. I can now open my wallet and bring out some money. I've been able to get an apartment for myself in town.
This is nice.
I just said I should let you know that I'll be moving into my house day after tomorrow.
is good.
I should just say thank you.
Come on, girl. You don't have to thank me. Come on. Oh, we're going to miss you greatly.
I'm going to miss you too. I'm going to miss the children. I'm going to miss...
Oh, but you know what? The first thing we'll do is you and I are going to go check the place out, okay?
Yeah.
And then, on that day, I guess we'll all walk into the house together. But for now, our usual celebration. Let's get it.
Oh, yeah.
Good afternoon.
How was school today?
Fine.
What's your school bag? In the car. In the car? As for you, you won't stop wearing boots to school, I mean, every time. Anyway, guys.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Felix, how are you?
I'm fine, ma'am.
All right, thanks for bringing them. Okay, darling. Let's go, we need to change.
Excuse me. Please, I want to tell you something. Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
Where?
I want you to watch your husband very closely this time around.
Watch my husband? Why?
For your safety, ma'am.
I don't understand.
See, madam, each time I see you, I feel like I just want
to... Stop it. I have told you to stop feeling anyhow. To be forewarned is to be forearmed.
No, madam, you don't understand.
Felix, I will not say this again. I am somebody else's wife. Stop feeling anyhow.
Men are stupid. Maybe she thought I want to tell her. Anyway, congratulations. Sarah, another woman.
It was a sulogy. It got wagon heavy. It gave me punala. Kige coronelu. Oh, magala. Jukeno wega juju. Mia hineme. Oh, the kwamma.
Chefu ono di njo ni hiyo tonko.